Hey guys, Charlie here, and today we are going to talk about how to reduce belly fat. I won't go into the technicalities of it. I just want to give you certain information which will be helpful in reducing the belly fat within 2 months, within 3 months, both for people who work out and for people who have sedentary lifestyle like 9-to-5 jobs and with a marriage or a competition coming up. You can easily reduce your body fat without like getting into a lot of science, because working a lot on your calories and writing things down will only complicate things and you will end up goofing up in the long run, and it will waste a lot of time, especially for those who don't have these kind of, like, people who are pursuing bodybuilding and fitness training as their sole professions can do that, but people who have 9-to-5 jobs and who have like other things to deal with, jobs and like professional life, they can't like write down calorie intakes every single time. So I will make things simpler for them, because the Groom with Charlie is like, this is Monday and this is more of a grooming session, and actually reducing belly fat is more of a grooming tip. Because if you have that protruding belly, regardless of you are a male or a female, you will not look as good as you want yourself to be. And the shirt won't fit in, the lehenga or the other dresses won't fit in. So it's important to get that belly fat in check in a very simple and very easy manner. So first we should understand, why do we get belly fat? Belly fat. Simple, there can be two reasons. Like 80% of the reason is that you eat more than you actually burn. As simple as that, we all know. That's logical. And second is the cortisol levels. Like if you take a lot of tension, if you don't sleep well, your body tends to release cortisol, which is more of a fat accumulator. So when people are under drugs, like they have asthma related drugs, all these kind of things, their body cortisol level increases. Cortisol is the anti-adrenaline thing. Adrenaline helps you reduce weight and keeps you all ripped and stuff. But what cortisol does, it helps in fat accumulation. So these are the two things which you should take a note of. And first thing to reduce your belly fat is to reduce your overall fat, because you all know, you must have heard it 100 times, that you cannot squat reduce fat. Like you can keep, if you're willing, if you're planning to like keep fat on your arms and reduce it on your belly, it's not possible. You need to go an overall cohesive methodology for reducing fat, and your belly will automatically disappear. So the first tip is to go on a calorie deficit. Calorie deficit means reduce the number of calories you eat, and the number of calories you eat should be lesser than the number of calories you burn. As simple as that. But there is a catch to it. There are two catches rather. First, a usual person or everyday person actually burns around 1300 calories without doing anything. Suppose you have a sedentary lifestyle and you are working in an office, you will still burn 1300 calories because of your organ functioning, normal works. 1300 is a staple. Like what, if you work out, if you run, if you do cardio, if you're into sports, it goes above 1300 and it adds on. So what I should do, if you can't reduce your calorie intake to 1300 or less than that, because actually that is the logic, you have to do that, but you can't do more than 1300 or less than 1300, because you will feel hungry and it will deteriorate with your health. No, you shouldn't do that. So what you can do is you should do some kind of physical activities. Like, I'm not telling you to work out or hit a gym, because that will be detrimental in the long run if you leave the gym. So first thing which you can do is to start walking, running. These kind of things you can do, like small. I will be giving a proper workout routine in my next video. So this is more of an overview. The first thing you can do is to like walk, run slightly. Like if you are too busy to go out in the morning, take your dinner and then you walk for at least 30-40 minutes. So these are the stuffs. And walking is like, this shouldn't be normal walking, like slowly you are ambling across the road. No, like the idea is to increase your heart rate so that it facilitates fat burning. So first, what you can do, you need to start walking fast, like for 2 to 3 minutes, then go slow for 2 minutes, then be fast. Like fast means proper fast, like the only the predecessing the jogging thing. Like don't run, but walk as if you're jogging. Run fast for 5 minutes, then 1 or 2 minutes, go it very slow, then go for 5 minutes again. So this increases your heart rate, which reduces your fat deposits. So this is the first thing. First thing is to go on a calorie deficit. Now when you are burning more calories, like 1300, you're walking around 10,000 steps a day. So the calorie output or the calorie expedited out of your body is 1800. Now you can afford to eat 1600 calories, like 200 calories you are decreasing each day. So within a week or so, you will notice differences. But now 1600 calories, if you eat all carbs, will that be enough? No, because carbs provide you energy. 1 gram of carbohydrate, suppose you're eating 80 grams of oats and it has 50 grams of carbohydrates. So 80 grams of oats, you think it's healthy? It is healthy. But if you take like 50 grams of carbohydrate from that, 15 to 4, like 1 gram of carbohydrate has 4 calories. So you're taking 200 calories just from the oats in one meal. So don't do that. What you should do is to take a lot of calorie from protein, because 1 gram of protein also has 4 gram of 4 calories. And you can also take good fats like almonds, you can have eggs, you can have extra virgin olive oil. Cook your food in that instead of the conventional oil. So if you're having fat as your primary source of energy instead of carbohydrates, you will automatically reduce fat, because your body will get a shock signal like, I need to reduce fat, I need to break down those fat deposits. So I will be discussing the thing about which I just told, it's called one part of a keto cycle or a carb cycle also I will define, which is very easy to follow for professionals even. So I will come to that when I will discuss a proper nutrition plan for reducing belly fat, not now. This is more of an overview as I told you. So what you can do, you can take most of your food from protein, like have fish, have chicken, it's like slightly cooked, not even boiled. Boiled won't give you any taste. Eggs, and you can have this, eggs, chicken, fish for vegetables. You can have beans, you can have legumes, you can have pulses, all these things you can have. And don't rely much on carbohydrates, like don't have rice, don't have bread. All these things try to avoid if you're going to reduce fat, because they will have negative implications. So this is the first thing, go for a calorie deficit. Even in a calorie deficit, try to run a bit, try to physically challenge yourself slightly. Workouts afterwards I will discuss. And take most of your food from protein and the remaining from fats. Go for very little carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are not good for you, not your friends, when it comes to losing fat, mostly the belly fat. Second is to stay hydrated. You need to drink loads and loads of water. I will suggest males to have at least 5 to 6 liters of water, and females also 4 to 5 liters of water on a daily basis, so that they can reduce weight. Because water, if your body is hydrated, you will stay emulsified longer. The fats will emulsify inside, will break down. Third, you need to have a lot of sleep. That is where the cortisol level like shoots. If you don't sleep more than 6 to 7 hours, your cortisol level will shoot up, and that will facilitate fat accumulation. So sleep a lot, that will help calm your senses, and your body will break down more fat. Next, what you can do, like small nutrition tips which I will give you in this video, have green tea every day upon waking up in the morning. Like have a small savory, a biscuit or something, and then have green tea. Don't have it empty stomach, and try to have green tea between meals. Most preferred is try to have green tea between meals. Suppose you had your lunch, the lunch got, you just has protein, you had slight amount of carbs. Then if you take green tea, that actually emulsifies the fat which you just had. So this is the idea behind reducing. Like green tea between meals is a fantastic thing. Before sleeping, going to sleep at night, 1 hour prior, like if there's a gap between your dinner and your sleeping, like 2 hours, after your dinner, 1 hour prior, after your dinner, you can have a cup of green tea, which is actually very good. Apart from that, upon waking up in the morning, you know all the chores, like have lemon, all these things, you can still have. But if you want to, and if you are a gym goer, if you go to a gym, you need to work out on your legs more. Because when you work out on your legs, for guys, it increases the buildup of testosterone or more compound movements, which will help you reduce belly fat even from the forward portion, even the back belly fat, like the love handles. So if you are working out in the gym, hit your legs more, because hitting your legs will actually amp up your fat losing goals. So hit your legs, go for workouts like deadlifts if you are a proper like hardcore gym goer, because deadlift is the only way to reduce like side fat properly, is to do compound movements like deadlifts. Now when you have talked about how to staying hydrated, sleeping a lot, and going in a calorie deficit, eating more of protein, less of carbohydrates, and even working on your legs, doing Surya Namaskar, all these things are the physical aspects. Now to come to supplements, like if you want to facilitate faster fat loss, I would suggest don't go for a fat burner, because fat burners are not as effective as they sound to be. You can have caffeine. Caffeine is a very natural fat burner. It's a very good thing, like black coffee you can have before working out. And people who don't work out, or like if you have office gym, or in the office you like try to take stairs, don't try to take the escalator, don't try to sit at one place. Keep moving. Like if you keep moving, you will reduce fat. You are eating less already, you're sleeping well, you are drinking loads of water. So like try to walk. That will like spice up things a bit. From spice, I remembered that you can have that, if you, bolte na mirch, you can have chilies, green chilies in your diet. Like, if you're, even if you're taking like very pale kind of food, try to incorporate green chilies, because capsaicin is such kind of an enzyme which actually cuts down your fat, it melts down your fat. So spices aren't bad, they aren't your enemies, you can have spices. And for supplements, I won't recommend you anything else, because many people can be diabetic, all these things, and all supplements might not be safe for them. So supplements should be people specific, and you want to know more about supplements, you can hit me in the comment section and I will reply to each one of you by upon asking your condition, like what condition you have, because every supplement won't be suiting everybody. But the basic supplement which everybody can use, which is safe, is calcium picolinate. You can find it over Amazon Health Card or like even New Life. It actually keeps your insulin in check. Mostly what happens when you just after workout or you eat foods like which are high in sucrose, fructose, your insulin level tends to spike up, which actually again helps you in accumulating fat. So this is what shouldn't be the case, and you should like take, you can take calcium picolinate before meals or an empty stomach, depending upon what you feel like how you need to have it. The dosages are already given in the bottle, but I would suggest you to have 50 mcg to 200 mcg just before the meal. This is how you can have calcium picolinate. That's a fantastic supplement. It even keeps your blood sugar levels in check and it helps facilitate weight loss, or rather fat loss, while preserving those muscles. And for people who work out, this is also for people who don't work out, people who properly work out, you can take branched-chain amino acids, especially Cybation Extend, which is a review I have made. I will post a link in the description. It's a fantastic supplement which will keep your muscle mass intact and it will help you reduce fat. So like, I'm just recapitulating the things, like you need to be in a calorie deficit, take good amounts of protein, negate carbs, like carbs, don't have carbs. Proper nutrition plan is coming up in the next video. And next is you should sleep a lot, around 8 hours, stay hydrated, 5 to 6 liters of water, hit your legs, do Surya Namaskar at home. Again, you can offer resistance band, which I have already shown a video of. It will help you build muscle and lose fat at the same time, it will help you make you ripped. Lastly, have green tea between the meals and before going to the sleep. Next, you can have black coffee as a natural fat burner if you intend to. Next point, or the last point, is to have calcium picolinate as this supplement. Don't go for fat burner, because every fat burner or every supplement won't be suiting you. And for people who go to the gym, also don't take a fat burner. Take a BCAA in branched-chain amino acid instead, which has upper like 4:1:1 or even 2:1:1 ratio of leucine, isoleucine and valine, because that will help facilitate fat loss. And Cybation Extend is a great option, because I have personally used it and the benefits are immense. It has zero calories, zero sugar, zero carbs, so go for it. So this is an overview of the fat loss program, or the belly fat loss program, which I just started. And more details, workout plan and nutrition plan will be coming up in subsequent videos. And today there will be another video posting, like how to become confident in 5 easy steps. So stay tuned for that, friends. Until then, stay healthy.